So hello guys, welcome to Bollywood Bubble Live. This is your host Drishti, Pathak, and I hope you guys are liking our lockdown edition. Today we're going to be connecting to my favorite Anjana Sukhani. I remember the last time I had a word with her was during Good News, and we had an amazing chat, and I can't wait to get connected to her all over again and figure out how her lockdown is going. So let's just wait for a moment till I get her request and then I can add her.
Hi!
Hello. How are you?
I am very well. Good. How are you?
I'm good. It's such a good news to have you on our live.
How's it going for you, the lockdown? Forget me.
The lockdown is exactly like sabka. We want to know ki aapka kaisa chal raha hai lockdown.
Honestly, I'm actually really enjoying it. Life has suddenly become very easy and slow. And I'm enjoying that pace because aapko pata hai ki ye zyada time last nahi karne wala hai. So make the most of it. You know that once everything starts getting back to normal, we'll be back in the rat race again. So so I think it's God has given this time to us to reflect and contemplate and make the right choices in life. And I just use that time wisely.
So since there are a lot of fans already watching you here, they would surely want to know what you do throughout the day. Tell us about your routine.
Oh God, you know, honestly, I feel my day goes so fast that I feel ki sham ho bhi gayi aur pata bhi nahi chala literally. So, couple of things that I try to keep myself engaged in. I watch a lot of shows on OTT platforms. I do my riyaz because I do intend to get into music as well, which is like a passion for me. So I do a lot of riyaz. I help my mother in the kitchen. I also do utensils because the maids are not allowed, obviously. So, you know, you don't want to put pressure on just one person in the house. So I help my mom with cooking. Sometimes I cook as well, though I'm pretty average, I would say. I'm not that good, but getting there. And then, read a book. By the time I think it's, and then work out. So a little bit of discipline life we are trying to lead irrespective of the lockdown. Sometimes you get to the market and buy some stuff every few days. And then time just goes by.
Anjana, I wanted to ask you now, I've been following you on Instagram. I keep watching your posts and you usually put up a lot of wise words for people, you know, some quotes that really make sense. And very less people in the world are somebody who wants to give others a nice lesson. So tell us what makes you do that? What makes you give us these quotes that are really beautiful?
You know, I started doing it from January onwards because I realized that, you know, words have so much power. You know, words, like when you read books, you get influenced so much. And you never know who's reading that quote for that day is apt for somebody. Whether somebody's feeling low or somebody not feeling confident or somebody feeling overconfident. I think it just kind of helps to balance your life out that not everything is about running. Not everything is about just gathering and greeting. Not everything is about just being in a race, and not everything is about just being negative all the time. So I think these quotes kind of help me, and I hope through me, these quotes that I put, I hope it helps. I hope that it does help other people as well. I mean, I really hope so.
Your posts do help. In fact, even in our last interview, you helped so many people when you opened up about so many things to do with life, to do with the mental health. You spoke so much and it really helped. It helped me as well. I went and consulted a doctor as well after your recommendation. And but now, you know, they say that people who go through it, only they know about it. Now since it's coronavirus, it's a very bigger thing happening in the world. But jinko dard hai, jinka mind waha pe hi atka hua hai, wo wahi rahenge. What would one do in a lockdown? How would one heal in a lockdown?
I agree with you that, you know, especially in a situation when we are locked into our houses and it can get very difficult for people who are, you know, are challenged with mental disorders because you need to breathe out. You need to get out. When you're closer to nature, you feel so much better. When I go for a walk, I mean, when I used to go for a walk or a run or a jog, it would make you feel so much better because you're closer to the beach, you're closer to nature, to the trees. And now because of this lockdown, that is absolutely not possible. What works for me is I put a lot of soothing sounds in my home. Mm-hmm. So if you go to YouTube, you have these lot of farm music available. So there's chirping birds and running water. And I love jazz music. So I put a lot of jazz music in my house. And I think you just have to find ways to keep yourself diverted. And, you know, we are also very blessed that we live in the age of internet and globalization of the web world. And so nothing is really further away. Today, if I want to, say, learn a language, all I have to do is just go on Google. And so I started learning a little bit of Spanish now. I mean, I used to know, but, you know, I missed out. There was a huge gap, so I'm, like, catching up on that. And, you know, things, you have to find little ways to keep yourself occupied and happy. And I think everybody knows what they really have to do. You just need to push yourself, I guess, a little bit. That's it.
Very well said. And again, another tip noted. We're going to go listen to
Star music.
Okay, so tell me now, during this lockdown, because obviously this pandemic has hit the world very hard, sabka kaam atak chuka hai. So was there anything that you were doing that got stuck and you are looking forward to resuming it?
Yeah, we were going to resume shooting for Mumbai Saga, and it was literally last few days left, and I think because of the virus, obviously the shootings had to be called off because of, you know, you couldn't have so many, a crew of 300 people at the same spot. So, but I guess we will resume again. I mean, I know that this is temporary, and I always believe whatever comes, it has to pass. It's, everything is in transition in the world. So whatever's coming is also going to be on its way to go out. And this will go, it might take a little while, but we just need to be patient and let it pass, yeah.
So, you know, the last we had a conversation was during Good News Promotions, and I told you that we will meet again when it's a, you know, a blockbuster party ki wo hit ho jayegi, and we'll probably, you know, interview you for that. But then hum mil nahi paaye, and it's never too late. Tell me, how do you feel after all the love that you've got for the film? There was so much that people spoke of, you know,
yes,
spoke of
you. Yes, and I am so glad that the film turned out to be the most hilarious film I have seen in the last few years. And also very sensitive, other than hilarious, of course. I've truly enjoyed a lot of adulation coming my way, a lot of love coming my way, a lot of recognition coming my way. So I think you just have to feel happy and blessed and have gratitude towards it. And then that helps you to, you know, strive better, do better work, and not let your fans down. And just go with the flow.
But you honestly acted like you never took a break. You were always here. That's what
but
it looked like.
I never really took a, I mean, you know, I don't know. You know, anyways, you have to understand one thing, that films do take some, and especially with, you know, films with bigger artists, do take a lot of time in making. You know, not every film make gets done in like 35, 40 days. So, yeah, maybe there was a break of like a year and a half where I completely just cut off. But I honestly, when I didn't feel like I was cut off completely, and I was not in tune with what was happening at all. But I guess it all worked out nice for me, so no complaints.
Oh, we are so happy. Okay, so I'm going to ask you one question about this lockdown. Now, everyone is actually very serious and strict about this and sitting at home, whereas there are still some people who are taking it very lightly, and we all know about that. They're still roaming outside and being mean to cops and all. What is it that you would tell them so that they sit
home? You know, it's really sad, because we have to first and foremost understand that the cops also have family. They also have children. They're standing, like everybody's using this statement saying that they are the first line of defense, and we are pushing them towards, you know, the more outside we are, the more they are susceptible to catching it more quickly, because you never know. So, you know, if not for anything else, just be more human and understand that the doctors, the nurses, the compounders, the, you know, the basic medical staff, the cops, they all are only trying to do their duty for our safety, not for them. They would happily want to be home and, you know, be with their families and be safe. But they're doing this for us. And I think kuch logon ki wajah se ye unnecessary situation jo create ho rahi hai, wo kisi ke liye bhi achhi nahi hai. On the whole, humanity ke liye achhi nahi hai. Kyunki if we are going to be at doing this continuously, we will only be continuously spreading this virus rather than be able to control it. I am hoping to really comment on it, but I think if you ask your conscience, then you will know that you are wrong or right. and let that be your judge more than anybody else. You know, just make sure that if your life is important, other people's life is important too, and their families too. So for that sake, stay home.
Okay, lovely said. I also wanted to ask you, see, there are a lot of people who are putting in a little bit of efforts towards the country. Somebody are, you know, kind of donating food, koi paise donate kare, koi animals ko help kar raha hai, koi fitness classes online kar raha hai. So what is it that you've thought that you, you know, would do for the world?
You know, I feel that not everything is really publicized. I mean, you do publicize it because it gives somebody else, you know, an idea to go kar sakte hain, toh hum bhi apni taraf se kuch kar sakte hain. And I think everybody at their own level does as much as, you know, they can. I hate talking about this, but I do understand that as an artist, there is a certain responsibility that, you know, that we have. And I'm very happy and proud that actually my building secretary, actually, she thanked me yesterday because I've been taking care of an elderly couple who live right off.
Wow.
And obviously, she must be like 70 plus, 75 plus or something. And obviously, we understand that for them to go down, buy groceries or even cook is a very difficult thing, you know, because they're used to the help coming in and cooking for them and cleaning for them. So in my own little way, that, you know, we can, as much as we are able to be there for them and chat with them every day, just so that there's a little bit of, wo lagta hai na, thoda apna pan hota hai aur aisa lagta hai ki koi hai, hum akele nahi reh gaye hain. So, and especially for elders, they feel lonely faster. For them, it's also more difficult, you know, because you can't even get down. Like for us, we can at least get down every few days and get groceries and everything. At least we are able to still see some world outside. For them, they're just like literally caged in their house. Then we have our watchmen, the watchmen that are there in the building, we take care of them. I think it has to be a combined human effort. It is not an individual thing. And I'm sure I am not the only one who thinks like that. Everybody who has a heart, I'm sure they think like that. That in smallest way that they can, they want to help people out in a situation like that. I guess that's it.
I know, though you don't like talking about it, but it's so beautiful to hear something like this, and it gives inspiration to so many. I'm sure that there are still a lot of people who haven't made an effort.
Maybe
so
people actually don't even need inspiration, because at the end of the day, we all have a human heart, and the core of it is always will be love and compassion. And I think you just need to look inside it, yeah? You just need to feel other people's pain to know that it's painful and to be able to help them accordingly.
Okay. Now everybody about this lockdown, everybody has their own brain. Koi kehta hai extend hoga, koi kehta nahi extend hoga. What is your anticipation?
I have no idea, baby. I am absolutely clueless what the hell is going on. Honestly, I stopped reading about it almost about a week, 10 days ago when the lockdown was announced. I started avoiding reading much or hearing too much news about it. Of course, I mean, generally, I want to know that, you know, how many cases are happening or how are people, you know, recuperating or how many people have recuperated and everything else. But I avoid too much of in-depth knowledge of this because I don't want to know. I would rather pray and be positive than see all of that and be negative about it. So I just want to see what good is going to come out of it. The good is that God has given us chance to be able to spend time with our families, which we always crave. He's given us time to pursue things that we always wanted to do and were not able to do. Say for me, music, language, or an instrument, or to spending time with my mom. To be able to connect with friends. Like, I am also doing a lot of what is called WhatsApp video chats with my friends across the world. And that's amazing, you know, people you lost contact with, you want to reconnect with them. So there's so many good that is going to come out of it. And I would just say, let's try and look the more positive side of it then. Because the more positive we feel, I hope the lesser number of lives we lose, not lose to this virus. So at least works for me.
I'm gonna now ask you a girly question. Since you're wearing no makeup at all, and I see that you have no pimples, nothing.
Pimples,
how do you manage
have,
to do this
have,
at home?
I have worn a little bit of makeup. See, I want to look pretty. Also, because I've done dress up for so many days, I said, "Ab chance mila hai, thodi lipstick lagayenge."
But then I can obviously figure out your skin. So tell me, what is that home care that you're doing so we can copy you?
I do shitloads of home care, dude. Like, I think my mother thinks I've like lost the plot. Because not just skincare, even hair. So we are vegetarian, so we don't eat meat or anything. So I told my mom, listen, I want to put this. I have like this really dry hair. And I was like, I want to put egg in my hair, and she's like, are you crazy? So I said, mom, please let me at least try it once, you know, because they say that egg is like really nice on protein and everything. It strengthens the hair, so I really want to use it. So the other day, I used olive oil and beat an egg with it, and I put it in my hair. And my mother didn't come near me for 6 hours. So I'm going crazy with all, like, basically all home, what is it called, ingredients to use for face and skin and hair and everything. So turmeric is my, like, go-to. Turmeric and honey is, like, my go-to mask for the face. Lemon and honey is also great for turmeric. Then besan is great. Besan with dahi and nimbu is again very great for skin. And I anyways don't believe in facials. I don't think so. I think probably I got a facial done maybe once in my entire lifetime. I pretty much do everything that's got to do with stuff with home. So, and maybe I'm also naturally blessed that I don't have an acne prone skin. So yeah, easy for me.
Yeah, so we're gonna take note of the turmeric and the honey and the anda.
Yeah, it's great for skin.
Also, okay, so I'm not gonna take a lot of questions now. This is my second last question. Once the lockdown goes off, what is the first thing that you're going to rush to do apart from work and gym?
I'm gonna go and have bhel puri and pani puri.
Oh my god, tell me about it. Chat.
I'm dying to have pani puri. I'm like dying to have pani puri. That's the first thing I'll do. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of people are in the same boat with you. Yep. Sabko khani hai pani
puri. Please join me where I go.
And lastly, there are a lot of fan clubs. There are a lot of people who love you and keep posting for you. Ho sakta hai kabhi kabhi hum sabse nahi baat kar paaye. To aaj ek saath sabko bata hi do how much you love them.
I am just, you know, actually, so this is in my prayer every day. That I every day thank my fans for care for me and for their good health and for their family's good health and their prosperity every single day of my life. So all I just want to tell you guys that thank you for having my back always, and thank you for always sending me so much of love and appreciation. And I do think about you guys all the time, and you are always in my prayer. And for now, but just for today, after this duration that we are facing right now, this challenge that we are facing in life right now, please stay home, please stay safe, and take care of your parents. Don't let them step out no matter what. And rest is good. They're going to chill. Enjoy it. Don't worry.
That was such cute words for your fans. And I would like to tell you that, Anjana, you're somebody who has an amazing, a really positive aura. I always enjoy talking to you. And I did even today. So on that note,
virtual hug.
We really, really love you. I hope you stay home and stay safe. I hope you like talking to us.
Absolutely enjoyed it.
So thank you for coming live, and I hope that things go fine soon and we meet again.
Oh yes, absolutely. I'm sure that's not really far away, you know. Pretty much around the corner.
Thank you so much for being
thank
here.
You
thank
that.
You.
Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.
Bye. So guys, that was the beautiful Anjana Sukhani with us. I hope you liked the conversation. I did try to ask her about something related to mental health, because I'm sure a lot of us go through a little bit of problems in our lives. I hope her tips helped you, and we will come again with another live. Until then, stay home, stay safe. This was your host, Drishti Pathak. Bye.